Morning. I'm going to start by tying a loose end, or maybe a couple of loose ends, that I figured out yesterday when I did my status report. And one of those is that, and this is the right shell, that I can't actually extract a archive from Nautilus itself. So I'm pretty convinced that Nautilus runs file roller. I'm not 100% sure, but let's have a look at that. I'll search mavcts yesterday and then grep nauts t grep froller. Okay, that's gap and not grep. So it's early. Just got up. So yeah, you have here some a couple of executes. So yeah, we need to take care of that. Let's just do that. Nano. My login user. Type a forcing file. Then go to Nout. And that's not this Nout. This Nout. It's actually we need to go to Froller though. Froller. So we have a couple of so actually not only gnome shell is running Froller, but also my login user Nout is doing that. Let's just get that off our chests. I'm sorry. She has a little bit of oh. Damn. Okay. Where are we right now? That should be it. Keep this built. Install it. And just check that out first. So that we can get that out of the way. We might actually also need to be able, for example, to run a shell script. So I might try to do that as well. So these are small things. And if all is well, we're still in a forcing mode. Let's just try this. So basically, you start. Oh, yeah, actually, we already have a tar gzip. So let's try and extract this here. And There we go. See if we have any ABC denials that are recent. We have some stuff, yeah. Rename. That we need to be able to rename. Oh, rename. Do a couple more times. Might be overlooking something. Although we have some updates here, so we have this test here, and then move this to trash, move to trash, try this again. And now we actually have it. Let's see if we have some more ABC denials. No, so yeah, that seems to be fixed. So that was a tidbit that I basically noticed yesterday when I did my status report. Now there's some other thing that I'd like to just test. Not sure. I'm not really sure about this, but let's just assume you're creating a file. So and we have a cannot create temp file here document. Ain't that something? Ain't that something? You kidding me? So just to do this, you actually need access to temp. That's messy indeed. And if I do it the other way around. See if we can actually make it executable. If I do it right. And that actually also works. Actually doesn't work. You kidding me? See if that has some Oh, I do minus x, and I need plus x, obviously. But it does spit some ABC denials. I should actually hide those. Or actually deal with those. I'm not sure if I need to hide those. It's basically a design decision. Oh yeah, so that works. So now we have that, my script file here. And basically it only yeah, it doesn't do anything. Let's see what that's all about. Doesn't know any available bin execute. And oh yeah, and it can't actually run the file. So yeah, in that sense. Let's just grab note D. What's happening here is that Nautilus is trying to execute my script, and then it's trying to execute the edit, which are both denied. Because, well, the edit we don't have it confined yet. And, and we haven't allowed our user to actually execute the content in the user home directory. So that's, yeah, probably something that we might need to consider, or yeah, not sure really, so let's just ignore that for now. And also, this is that weird thing that it basically puts those locks on the files. And I basically think that this has to do with Nautilus not being able to read or write the files. I'm not sure why this is. Maybe SEModuleDB reveals something. But yeah, I basically denied a lot of stuff on purpose to hide stuff, and probably a little bit too early. Now it would be nice if we actually figured out what's causing what. So let's see if I can do this. That actually works. So now it creates that icon with a lock. File roller actually executes that file. kind of a dilemma. But as for Nautilus actually writing, it's actually hard to tell. This shouldn't be allowed. But the right, that's really something I should just check out. So yeah, there's some stuff that needs to be ironed out. And yeah, it's not the kind of stuff that really is important though. But try this. I'll just do it the other way. Oops. Test. And then just write, allow write, just to see why, if it actually needs write for that icon, or if it's maybe something else, or something is actually making it so that it's actually creating these icons with a lock on it. That shouldn't be happening. Let's try this out. Now it's not creating it with a lock. So that's actually pretty damn weird. So I need to basically make a note to self in there. If I don't allow it to write, then it works, but Nautilus is then basically thing is that here above I added a rule where I allow Nautilus to basically out it access on any user home type. So that would mean that Nautilus would be able to basically check for write on any type that is defined user home type. And I can look that up, but se info and then xt user home t will show you that it's a user home type. So there's something fishy going on here. Especially fishy because, well, it doesn't show you locks at any of these dirs. These dirs are also rather weird. See, if I create a dir here, then it doesn't put a lock on it. That's kind of weird behavior. So am I overlooking something? Yeah, so basically that's just a shitty situation because, yeah, I don't actually want Nautilus to be able to right. You know what? I'm going to allow it anyways, because if you look at it, it can basically do anything almost. It can set attributes, it can rename, it can link and unlink, it can delete it. And especially when it comes to dirs, it can do anything, it can write to stuff. So yeah, I'm just going to allow this and get rid of the lock. But in practice, it doesn't really need to write, but because Nautilus doesn't actually write to files. It's at least I can't imagine how Nautilus writes to files. But it doesn't seem to be a check, because if it was a check, then the audit access rule above would have fixed that. Probably, if that works the way I expect it to work. So basically somehow it notices, okay, I can write to this file, I'm going to put a lock on it. But for us it doesn't matter, because I open the file for example in nano in the user domain, and I'm able to write to it, no problem. Or I open it in, for example, if I'm going to confine gedit, I open it, then gedit will be allowed to basically edit it on my behalf. But yeah, there's no reason actually to allow Nautilus to edit the file on my behalf, but yeah, it actually wants to be able to write, so I'll just deal with that. And yeah, really, this is just nitpicking, of course, because I said before in previous episodes, generic user home content should just be accessible by any confined domain. So I'm just nitpicking. I should just allow this and get it over with. But you know, those are the small little things that I'd like to deal with, but that's just over the top. So yeah, we took care of this. So as in module B, right over that. I'll just delete these. So now that works. You can basically create an archive, or yeah, create a PDF or a file, whatever. So you print a PDF. Oh, it's already there. Now it's there again. In documents, you can basically now it creates it without a lock. So that's cool. And then basically you can compress it without a problem. See? And then you can basically extract it without a problem. Then in recent. So that seems to all work. And we're enforcing, so yeah, seems to all work. So that's basically it for now with regard to this. So we're gonna have a look at what else we're going to confine, because we have so much stuff to do yet. Oops, not music, but documents. There's yet so much stuff to do. Look at AOC denials. Oh, right. We have some more stuff here. Trash. TomTomT, yeah, we have some TomTomT stuff. And once the search, now get attribute done as well. And we have a user home T the remove name. So yeah, small bits and pieces. Small bits and pieces, and that's part of the workflow. It just requires a lot of testing, but at least the functionality works. There might be some stuff hanging around. So let's have a look at what I'm going to focus on next. So one of the things that I've been that's been in my mind is Totem. Been on my mind. It's the movies of the videos suite. But yeah, there should also another. You know what? I should just stick to my plan. So I'm gonna log out. You know, I should just stick to my plan. It's so inviting to actually go do some stuff, other stuff now. But basically, kill all you, my login. User. And then there's clear my login user shell, and there's all the temp. It's so inviting to do that, and I have a lot of thumbs that weren't deleted. And that's basically because of that remove name that was not allowed, I think. Now I just need to stick to my plan, and it's it's not nice because I'd like to do the interesting stuff, of course. But you need to control yourself. So less, or actually nano, my login user, T FTE, and from the stuff in my to-do list I can choose. So what's in my to-do list? Not much left. So we have now this data convert, but I don't know Nautilus data convert, how that works. Nautilus send to, don't know how that, yeah, that I actually know how that works, but that probably requires some other stuff. Yep, we did. XML we did. DPTI helper. Return. Auto run. Node file roller, we did that. So we have data dub, which is a that's a shitty program to do. That needs access to a GPT and stuff like that. And we have eye of gnome. So I guess I need to focus on eye of gnome. Or connect server, one of the two. I'm just going to focus on eye of gnome. So how does eye of gnome get run? Well, basically either by the shell or by Nautilus, I guess. So do we have what program gets run by this, for example, gets run by either Nautilus or shell. So we can basically add that in. It's a duplicate here. Okay, I have gnome. Yeah, we should really focus on these basics. Although I have to say that I kind of don't like to do some of these like data dub and stuff. That's really, data dub is pretty hard to do because, well, it depends on a lot of stuff like GPG. And well, it's not hard to do, but it's basically one of those things that you'd like to wait with a little longer, because you first need to do GPT, and GPT, well, it's also pretty, well, it's actually not that complicated, but there's a lot of use cases with GPT. You can basically you have all these pin entries with GTK pin entry and a shell pin entry, and then you have like all kinds of commands and stuff, that's variables that you need to be able to support. So in that sense, it's actually not that easy. And as for what is it, that BitTorrent client, yeah, it's nice, but I doubt I'll ever use that. Or yeah, I will probably use it, but it's not like that common. But yeah, you need to basically control yourself. It's raining again. Okay, so let's just outsource. So we now set up at least a transition. And ABCTS 10 o'clock. And yeah, from another perspective now, of eye of gnome should be rather simple, so that would be nice, so that we can keep it simple today. So yeah, let's just try that out. see if I can actually create a screenshot somehow. Print screen, yeah, there is it. There it is. See if that actually works. Oh, that's probably a print screen. Oh, it's a send key. That doesn't work. Let's see what I get. Gnome screenshot, that doesn't work. Not allowed to make the screen cap. At least not from... Let's see how do you create a screen cap from the shell. Linux screen cap shell. Taking a screenshot from the shell. Now hopefully oh, that's never going to work. That's never going to work, or is it? Let's open shell. Can't even paste. Okay, so I'm gonna have to do this the hard way. It's probably not even gonna work. So import window and then yeah. It's not gonna work. There's no screenshots for me. Is that as Linux blocking? Yeah. Yeah, that's as Linux blocking. So you're actually trying to do something then. It actually doesn't work, of course. But yeah, consider that a security feature. You're just not able to do that. Although, no, yeah, you're just not able to do it. Because, well, some wannabe smart guy would say, okay, let's just run what is it? Oh, that's GNOME 7's daemon. Daemon actually was trying to execute. Let's just run GNOME shell screenshot from a terminal, and then it would run in the user domain. Yeah, that's true. But yeah, theoretically that's true. But then it wouldn't be able to run because the shell session, the shell domain has so little domains. So little permissions, so that wouldn't work either. So there's basically no way. Now, for now, we'll just call that a security feature. Alright? But that just and am I able to go to user share and open a file from there. User share. Background. normalish. So I'm able to do that. And then I'd be able to run it in the image viewer. So in that sense, so yeah, that should be workable. 740. And just open this one in the image viewer. So this is Eye of Gnome, I think. Let's see what AOCD now we get with regard to that. Hello. So there's no screenshots for us. So we need to take care of this. And then later this as well, because this probably is a mislabeled file. Yeah, it's obviously a mislabeled file. There shouldn't be any files with data on team. But here it's actually creating a file, and we need to type transition there. But we need to just take a look first. First add this in and fix all of your stuff. Make some order in this stuff here. So yeah, there's some obvious stuff that we need to do first. You know the routine by now. And events has a lot of this common stuff as well. So yeah, for example, X server, that's one of those things. So yeah, that's shitty that you have to do the less interesting stuff to get to the more interesting stuff, but it's yeah probably just a better idea to do the defaults first, really. That's executing itself actually, or it's trying to execute itself, probably checking for execute. This one here use tempty, or but use temp fasty, and these 2, 3, 4. Then you have that deconf stuff and fonts, which are also obvious. This is also obvious. So remove that as well. Then it's basically fonts. The common stuff. So it starts raining again, so that's bad for my bronchitis. So it's probably going to start coughing and stuff. It happens. Then you need to have yeah, the basics with regard to well, actually it's reading thumbs. But let's just start with the first things first. So yeah, it needs to basically traverse user home. So that. Not this one here. We need some basic stuff. This one here. These. Actually, let's just copy these over because these are all applicable, I think. I will go through them. But I think they're all applicable. I'm pretty sure. And that's EOG, not OAG. Now, eventually, that's also just pretty shitty because I'm not going to allow. Oh, actually, yeah, I am going to allow EOG. Probably, EOG will probably be able by default to execute generic user files. So in that sense, so gconf traverse home root traverse user home dir traverse, and then you have gconf read file, gconf home file. Which is that's also allowed, that we also support. Then you have that recently used data. It needs to be able to do that. So we need to find somewhere that actually uses that recently used, and that might be actually events. Yep. So it's a nice thing with these templates, you can basically quickly get all or most of the rules, which will save you a lot of time. So that's yeah, probably this stuff here, but we'll verify that. But recently used. We have thumbnail cache. Which reads, so let's just add that as well. Oops, yeah, not this one, but this one. First it's actually, let's just do that this way. So to be able to actually get to a thumbnail's cache, you'll actually need to be able to traverse cache as well. And it seems it's only one to read the thumbnails cache. So yeah, that takes care of that. And now we basically need to, most of this other stuff can remain, except then those file type transitions. We need to have a look at them and see what that's all about. It's trying to create a Durham config, and it's trying to create a file in data home, and that file is probably that recently used data home file. So we can probably at least remove the data home tree, but we need to take care of config. So let's have a look. So let's grab create. And have a look what it creates. So it's actually creating an eye of gnome dir. And this is allowed already. And this recently used. So the data home stuff is actually fine. So we can remove that. Let's do that first. So that we don't get confused. And with regards to config, we basically need to take care of that. So let's have a look. LS alt z home, my login user, and then config, and then you'll probably see an eye of gnome there, which is created with a generic type. So what we need to do is basically first add a file context specification, then add a type transition rule and allow eye of gnome to create its eye of gnome directory in there. So let's first start by creating a file context specification for config. So I'll just eye of gnome. I have gnome config, and that's there. Then let's go back to type enforcement file and take care of that as well. So I'm just going to do that here. So we have a type IOG EOG config home d. Yeah, and then I'll just actually do that two times and then make that type attribute, and this is a file type. Now I need to put my keyboard in the right position. I'll just copy this one over and then use a home type. So now it's classified properly, and now I can basically add some rules in there. So basically it might be a good idea to actually let's just keep it simple for now. So because eventually it's going to actually create something in there, that's obvious. That's why I basically first I'm allowing to basically and I'm not going to let it create a generic config obviously, but I am going to create it allow it to create a eye of gnome config dir, because that's that actual dir. But it needs to be able to write to the generic config dir, because it needs to add an entry there. So type transition. Transition, and that's eye of gnome creating that eye of gnome config home tether in a config home tether. Eye of gnome config home t. And then we can use a name type transition, EOG. And that's that, taken care of, at least for now. So yeah, we have a couple of stuff here right now, but we also have some debug chatting going on. So let's just less for log messages and go to the end. And then here we have some debug chatting. So where we are, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. I'm going to do this one as well. I'm gonna have a look at this one as well. So yeah, 30 or something. Till end 30. Although, actually, no. Not. I'm not sure because I was in permissive mode at some time, so I wouldn't want to do anything stupid. So best to just ignore some stuff that I'm not sure about. That all? No, it's not all. I'm just going to do the stuff that I'm certain about, which is this stuff here. And not this. I can't be sure about this right now. So we're going back to our type enforcement file and go to back to ifgnome session and add some dbus related stuff in there. And we'll do that all the way below. So this is basically bidirectional. This is not bidirectional, this is just one way, because it's the user session bus and not some application bus. So this is duplicate dual or bidirectional. Deconf. This is also bidirectional. And this is also bidirectional. Okay. Now basically need to have a look at some of this functionality here. Let's just first save and make and save and do stuff like that, because we have the obvious things right now. For now, I'll just basically restore con the eye of gnome there and the recently used data. So restore, actually I'll just restore con rv f the whole home my login user just to see what all it's resetting. So this is an obvious thing here. Because this is basically, it's resetting it because of the system view, because I specified 4, so this is just not something I need to be fixing. So here we have cached thumbnails, and it's resetting it to thumb home t. Damned. And this is something I need to basically be aware of. I'm going to have to fix this. Because I'll explain that to you. Because, well, Fedora has obviously temp home t defined for the temp stuff in cache home t. So my type was temp cache home t, but Fedora has is different, something different defined. So that's why it's that's why it's basically changing it. And this other stuff, TDM. It's basically just reset because of the identity field. gnome that we just fixed that. Music is also not related, and this was because it was created with the wrong type. So that's so basically we need to fix something here. So temp cache empty is not temp cache empty, but it's temp empty. So fc temp empty, where are you? And actually I'll just temp empty, and we can just basically remove, oh yeah, of course, temp cache empty, temp cache home t. We can basically just, well, I'll be damned. Oh yeah, that's thumbnails, isn't it? Thumbnails cache empty. So we can basically remove that, and then in the type enforcement file, look for thumbnails cache home t, and change this all to thumb home t because we want to basically integrate with Fedora. We don't want to break Fedora. We want to play nice with Fedora. So in that sense, we just need to basically go by their rules, and all they use a different type, and that's okay with me. So this can be removed, but we need to require type temp empty if we haven't required that yet. Okay, go look. Oops. So it's a good idea to once in a while run a restore con on your dir to see what stuff was not done correctly, and then fix that. Because obviously in a perfect world, when you run restore con, it shouldn't reset anything. If it doesn't reset anything, then you know you're doing it right most of the time. So now we are done. Let's build this again, install it. They know you're doing it right. Now it's done right. But there are some issues that I really have an issue with. For example, audio home key, that's something I really have an issue with. It really is breaking my design model. And well, these and most of this other stuff is just related to the identity field. Because basically some process that runs in as XDM or GDM basically creates stuff in the user home dir, so you get these identity fields with system U. But yeah, that's something just cosmetic, so that's no problem. Alright, so where was I? Oh yeah, let's data home t, but it's already fixed there as well, because it actually fixed the recently used XBL file, so we can ignore that as well. So we need to basically just have a look at our search, or our search, and let's see if we're clean, and then just have a look at some of the stuff we're supposed to be able to do. So if am I supposed to, yeah, I'm supposed to be able to actually save the image as. So I need to actually and print. So we get the print menu all the way out. So this stuff, it's the same as with we need to transition also to events here for the print preview. And we have Yelp. We need to be able to save to generic content. So let's just take care of some of the obvious stuff first. The obvious stuff is this. Rinse Yelp. That's obvious. So that takes care of running Yelp from gnome. And then we need to take care of it basically managing user home content. So basically we can borrow some stuff. I'm going way too high from our boys at. So now I know that I actually need this one instead of. Because I need to be able to open the file thing, and then also all this stuff, this metadata is also coming to play. So there's a lot of stuff still to fix. So let's just change this first. Where is it? Where are you? Where are you? Oh, here it is. So we're changing this one here to this. Then coming to print, yeah, I need to take care of that as well, the coming to print stuff. And then you have this stuff here that I need to take care of. It's also pretty obvious that it needs to create content in the user home directory. It's only a file, that's right. Although this one here, I'll just leave this out for now, but I need it eventually. So yeah, that allows us to create, to save as. Let's have a look at some of the stuff that was generated. Yeah, see, this is some of the stuff that I can just basically borrow from events. Because in events I had this nice subsection needed for print, common to print. So yeah, that allows me to actually copy that over. I'll just also keep that common to print comment in there. So that I'll just put that above people, so but here. So common to print. and paste that in. And it was also searching dbus for libd. I'm not sure if events is also searching dbus for libd, system dbus for libd. I'm just going to make this one section so that I'm not getting confused with the dbus related stuff. So does Eye of Gloom search dbus for like to events? System dbus for like to. Yeah, it does. Probably also related to printing though, because eventually at some point if you want to print, then you want to basically chat to CUPS, and CUPS is a system dbus service, so you'll need to basically connect to the system bus to be able to use that, and that's basically what's needed. But yeah, because I don't have a printer, I can't actually reproduce that. So yeah, I have no there's something I wanted to take care of the transition to events. So yeah, events, go back up to events, and then where are you, events? Yeah, so Nautilus, Yelp doesn't run events. Yeah, Yelp does run events. And then just add a new one here. Yeah, a lot of stuff runs events. And this is basically Eye of Gloom running events. So basically at some point we should just basically create a type attribute with run events, runs events. So because else this list is going to go way too big, because all these programs that allow you to print with that particular print menu, yeah, they all have this print preview message, which basically shows you the preview in events previewer, which is run in the events domain. Okay. So actually we should have done that right away. Well, but that's then for the next time. it's allowed, it's allowed, it's allowed, it's all allowed, except Ibis support. Ibis config home. Thus, and we have proc kernel read system state. So we go back, we go to events. Events also reads proc, I think. But also Ibis config. And also proc. So yeah, they have a lot of stuff in common. So Ibis. I'll just add it here. But it's actually not the right place to put it, but okay. This is actually not the right thing either. I could just add this here. It did build, but proc. Procty. Where is it? Where are you? Probably this xcg config on p is probably also required. And probably ice out also. There's still a lot of stuff that needs to be done, but we can't basically get too far ahead of ourselves. I'm just currently looking for it reading proc. Here it is. I'll just add that here. It's not really the right place either, but so oh yeah, let's just do that. Because else I'm going to else is going to become too complex. So I'll create a new attribute. Runs events. Then I just need to basically copy this over here and then just comment this so that I have some reference, because I need to basically edit these domains to run for runs events. Runs events. Else, yeah, it's getting too hard to fix later, or not too hard, but it's getting really a big job to fix this all. And now it's still reasonably contained, so best way to just fix it now. Best to fix it right now. So we're basically grouping types, all these four or five types, or how many are there? Oops, and this is... yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess that's so now I need to basically fix all these. So type my login user EOGT. Runs Yelp. Damn. And that actually makes sense. But still doesn't find it. Crying out loud. So I'll just do it this way. EOG. And then. What else do I have? Nout runs Yelp. Runs events. Yelp runs events. And shell runs events. That should take care of it. So I can remove this line here with a little luck. That should be taken care of with a little luck. And there's no such thing. Problem. I'll just need to require it here. And remove it here. Yeah, it's unfortunate, but there's some ordering issues in here. Seems. Yeah. So I just needed it to add it a little bit higher up in the chain. So basically, we should be pretty much I think at this point might be a good idea. Yeah, we need to stick to the plan, really. How unfortunate it is, you wanna hurry, rush, but you can't. we really need to just now test it with semi-module db and see what's left, and then test it in enforcing mode with semi-module b and see what's left, and that whole routine, say, let's say. So yeah, you want to rush because you think, yeah, you have it all figured out, but that's not true, not the case. So I'm gonna remove my stuff from temp, clear, start all clean. Now with semi-module db, I'm gonna test that app out, see where I get. So lsl temp rm rf temp, and then pulse audio. And then I'll search to see if it cleaned. And also just list the user home directory. It seems alright. semi-module db to expose hidden. You want to rush because, yeah, you think, okay, now I have it all. But you shouldn't rush. You should just do the routine step by step. Always stick to the steps. Because you always see the one time that you don't stick to the steps, the shit messes up. That's always the case. Same with where I say always take care of the domain transitions first. If you don't do that, then you're just going to mess up, really. Oh, we need to go into enforcing mode. Oh, actually, not. No, not. But we need to be very careful here. Because now we're in permissive mode, and we have the don't audit unloaded, and we basically need to open a file in the file browser in user. So it's going to spawn a shitload of ABC denials, which are unrelated. Because I don't have a simple PNG anywhere. So user share, and then where was that? Backgrounds, wasn't it? There was a background there, wasn't there? Yeah. And then I guess Spherical Cow, default, and then normalish. And then open that in the application in Image Viewer. And now have a look. And it's going to spawn a lot of ABC denials. And a lot of them are just not applicable. But we need to basically have a big overview to see what's happening. This all can be ignored. This all can be ignored. This all can be ignored. Can be ignored. Can be ignored. Can be ignored. Ignore. 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 And here you have all this stuff that we can ignore. It's Nautilus going nuts. Nautilus just wants to get attribute of everything and anything. See, Nautilus actually trying to read system web server content. Are you kidding me? It's just basically trying to get attribute of everything in the system. Well, a lot of it. But with regard to Eye of Gnome, I don't see much. Do we have anything eye-opening? Yeah, we have, but just not much. So we're pretty clean. Let's just run Yelp at 11. Let's see if that gives us something. We should be transitioning to Yelp, and that's working because you can actually see that Yelp is trying to append to the XDM home file. So that means that Yelp is running, and that the domain transition did happen. Let's go to the print menu. Print to file. Print. Let's see what's related. And there we have some stuff that's interesting. So yeah, some of the stuff was expected, like that XDG config home. That I already said that before. I think okay, I guess that's going to probably also be required. So let's just take care of that. But yeah, I don't make assumptions. Events. This events also does read that XDG config home here. So we need that for IO of GNOME as well. I'll just add that while already IBUS is. Change that to IO of GNOME. So that's at least one thing I've taken care of. And then we have it creating a file in IO of GNOME. So this it can just basically add IO of GNOME, and then we have some IO of GNOME config somewhere. Where is it? Where's my IO of GNOME config section? Here. And I'll paste this in here for just for reference space for now. So it's actually also trying to remove a dir inside IO of GNOME. So add that here. And then it's doing some file related stuff, so it can basically copy that all over here. This. I knew it was creating a file there, but we just weren't able to produce that at that point. Now we are. So yeah, that's that. And then basically it's creating a file in temp. So let's just copy that. And then EOG. And I'll paste it here. It's a little bit of messy. There's no structure in there. But yeah, that's not the least of my problems, I guess, right now. So we have a type EOG tempt. Type attribute. EOG tempt is a file type. But also a temp file type and a user temp type. And a user temp type. So, with regard to this, this seems okay. So yeah, the dir, with regard to the dir, it needs to add an entry to the slash temp and remove, so because it's actually deleting the temp file. And then it needs to create the file, but it needs to create it with the IO of GNOME temp type. And then we need a type transition. from tempty file to eog tempty, and we can't use a named file transition because files in temp should not be created with predictable names. So I'm just assuming that it's creating some file with some random suffix there. That should be the way it should be doing it. So yeah, we took care of that. As a module. Let's see if the print preview works the way it's supposed to be working. So we can't actually check out the printing because I don't have a printer. And actually I haven't also haven't tested all the other formats, just PDF. So there's still plenty loose ends there. Print. And then preview. And then it's basically previewing it in PDF, I guess. So let's see how that looks like, what that looks like. Now you'll probably also see related to events. And then you actually get this stuff here open. So the same was with Yelp probably, or yeah, might be with Yelp. Here we have some other stuff that we need to take care of though. And there's an unlink here. So yeah, there's still some stuff I need to take care of, and I need just take it easy and do it. Now I actually forgot what it was. It was I have gnome config home to file and link. PLG config home file and link. That's one. Then we have temp file rename. I have new temp file rename. Where's the temp stuff? Rename. What else do we have? This is not applicable anymore, but this is. And I'll just add that somewhere. Getting attribute of temp fast, not sure why that is, but it's probably some library that does that. This is allowed. And then we have here this this stuff that we need to basically have a look at. So we'll just copy that. It's Evans trying to read. So let's have a look at Evans to see if it's also doing that to Yelp temp files. Doesn't seem to be doing that to the Yelp temp file. Is it actually doing it to any temp files? That's weird. That's some weird stuff here. But yeah, okay, we're fine. So this probably needs more later. It's not opening it just to open it. It actually needs more. So let's just try that out. You know, because this is probably actually should be. Let's just check it out first. Can I just make and install? Let's just see if I can reproduce this. Let's first see if they're rather clean. And then print preview. Let's see. Unlink. It's opening it and unlinking it. But it's probably doing even more. So keep reproducing that till it's done. I don't think it's just opening it to unlink it, to be honest. Must be writing it or reading it at some point, but maybe it's just somehow not shown. Let's just see. It really actually doesn't show anything new, so I guess that's that. What else do we have? Save as. Where are we? My login user. I'll just save as one. Save as. That's weird. We are in a permissive mode, aren't we? Yeah. But I don't have the necessary permissions. That config home create and DTK. Oh, that's basically DTK probably. So it's now it's doing that bookmark stuff, or yeah, bookmarks. So let's just grab create. It's creating a DTK bookmark. Yeah. So we need to take care of that as well, and it's IF gnome. Yep. And Evins probably also does that, so we can steal that from Evins, that functionality. GTK. You gotta be kidding me, if Evins not. Yeah, Evins is doing that, of course. Of course. So yeah, we copy this over, put that in events. Now we already have that right admin for config home key. Oh no, we don't. Or do we? Yeah, we have. I have number. I think it's on the page. So we can remove that. But this needs to be taken care of. Okay. Still weird how I can't. I need to restore that file or that dir. Restore bone rvf home my login user, and then it's in config, isn't it? Yeah, now it's resetting the TTK stuff so that I'm but that's weird, so I can't actually open this file with image viewer, save as, and save in folder. Oh yeah, right, I was trying to save in the wrong folder, and that was not allowed. Save in folder pictures, that is allowed. Okay, let's see what we have. This is not allowed, that's cool. That shouldn't be allowed. It's actually trying to read bash. Then we have some stuff. So yeah, actually put a lot. And it also gives me a user D relabel too. So it's actually moving that. No, it's not. It's not. It's doing some stuff that it shouldn't be doing. See, not a smart ass here. Now, some of the stuff we can actually also use. I'm just making it clear here. So here we have some stuff that it's trying to relabel too, so don't out it. File type. Are you kidding me? This can be removed. Smartass. Relabel from. Yeah. Smartass. So this is basically reading sysfs, but there's also a dir involved here. So basically that's allow my login user eogt sysfs tdir get attribute and search, and might even need to read it. Pulse audio, so it actually wants to read the pulse audio file. I'm not sure which one that is though. This can be removed, so I need to take care of that. Metadata, ice out, and TTK, this can be removed. So we have some GTK stuff, but actually it wasn't enough probably. So copy GTK as that's weird. GTK, where did I add that GTK stuff? So yeah, that was already allowed, GTK. Let's paste it in here, let's just paste it in here for a while. To compare, read get attribute open. Read get attribute open and GTK home file. So yeah, this is just not applicable anymore. Okay, what else do we have? So that udev foreign t file, we need to have a look at that. We need to have a look at the pulse audio file. Bash home, that's probably fine. We need to basically also allow Nautilus this. Oops. Allow Nautilus this at least. Where is Naut? Naut. Let's allow Nautilus to read the bash home file. Maybe not strictly needed, but I know it wanted that. Oh, and here's that ice out, so that's also so something that I can ignore. And then EOG. So ice out is also taken care of here, but metadata, data home key, let's see what that's all about. But this is also a dir involved there. Metadata, data home key. So, metadata. Yeah, see? So this metadata stuff can be replaced here. This can be removed, it already allowed that. So basically all we're having left is that pulse audio home file. Now I need to see if that, and you that for foreign T. So save and exit. Grab pulse audio. And you that grab pulse audio. See what that is, if that's the ESD file. No, it's it's pulse cookie, so. So it's pulse cookie, so that's fine. Now udev, grab udev. And it's reading, run udev, data. So actually it's reading a file, but actually to be able to read that file, you'll need to traverse. LSLZ. Run udev, and others do this as well. So that's udev problem T, and it's actually reading that file inside data. So yeah, it needs to just traverse a lot of stuff. So back, we are going to search for udev foreign T and see foreign T. Others do this as well, so it's not something new. Copy that, and then basically go to I have gnome, all the way below where the udev rule is, and then just add this one here because, well, it's and it's not org, it's EOG. Really need to basically also have a look at Nautilus, because Nautilus might need some of this stuff as well, like udev foreign T. Let's see if I can actually look that up. Grab yesterday, then grab Knout, grab UDEV, see what I get, and I was probably less. You see, yeah, Nautilus also wants that. Happening here. Nautilus is actually getting attribute and then pull running the Nautilus. So yeah, Nautilus also needs that. Search for EOG. Go back, go below where I added that. And then just also allow that for Nautilus. But the that Eye of Gnome stuff. Nah, it does it. It did it right. It's just a misinterpretation. I get. I'm not sure what's happening there with the relabeling. Not sure. And as for this stuff, Nautilus has it right. This far life, everything that basically searches deepest far life key wants to eventually also connect to the system bus. So I can just basically add that. So where is system deepest key far life key? It's just, yeah, you, at some point you just know that. And it, this has to do with printing. It's just really simple. It has to do with printing. It wants to basically debus check to cups, and to be able to do that you need to actually connect to the system bus. Or stream connect to the system bus. And to be able to stream connect to the system bus you need to actually write that sock file. So that's actually another rule related to that. This one's probably already allowed to. Well, this one's probably a special case. And here, as you see, it's also allowed here to pulse audio for this set. Not here. Messy? GCL also does it. In a sec. For example, might want to stream connect to network manager or that DNSSEC, DNS daemon. A lot of messy stuff still though. yeah, some other stuff is still questionable. Canberra, I don't think Canberra actually needs to be boosted yet. But still, this needs to be cleaned up. Yeah, this also needs it. Sure why this should need it, but well, if I'm not sure, I'm not gonna do it, but at least clean up some of this stuff. File roller doesn't actually with regard to printing, it's yeah, it makes sense. So where we got to printing, it just makes sense. And then also that Unix that connect to this is also related. This doesn't make sense. Alright, now I understand how that is with gnome. They probably, all domains are probably already allowed to search SysFS. And that's why it's only have only has a read here. Already, I thought I already changed it. This I do this just because it's related, so it gives an easier view. So let's go first to IFGNOME. To SysFS. So it's actually not this, but it's just read and probably also open at some point, but let's add read. And with regard to it actually getting to that system Davis sock file, yeah, it's probably actually just see it's going to want to it's going to want to check two cups. But why did I add it? When you don't have no when you don't organize the rules, stuff ends up everywhere and nowhere. Yeah, here it is. this basically needs a stream connect as well to the system bus. So basically I should just dbus d twilight d should basically take care of that. This is the one that doesn't have it. So yeah, this is right. This is the right block. This is the way it should look. Some of them are exceptions to the rule. This already has it. This already has it. PA control, yeah, it's another exception to the rule, I guess. This already has it. But this one. Probably needs to basically trying to make it a little bit more readable. Canberra is an exception. Even just not an exception. Because that's printing, everything that prints, I could basically just add this in the printing section where, because it's just related to printing. Yeah, so okay, see if it still builds. Because I'm kind of just messing a little bit. Messing up a little bit. But just cleaning up and reorganizing some stuff and just tying some loose ends, but also making some assumptions that, yeah, to be honest, that's not a good idea, but this isn't that big, so in that sense. All right, so now I'm just probably going to do the next phase. Which is testing it in a forcing mode with SE with don't audits. And then testing it in forcing mode without don't audits, and then some point I should be done. But before I go anywhere, I'll do a kill all you my login user, and then I clear my login user shell ls all z home my login user and a ls all z temp. Was able to create all the other temporary files, so that's cool. RM, RF, temp, and then basically set and force one, and then out search HCTS 1139 audit to allow less. We're clean. So now we're enforcing. But we still have the don't audits, so we still see a lot of stuff that we shouldn't see. So we're opening the thing and we're going to user, which is allowed, share, backgrounds, and then spherical cow and then normalish, open that with your image viewer, and it's opening it. So far so good. Let's just print preview. Seems to work. Let's just print to file. Seems to work. Let's just save as. I'll just save this in my home directory. Seems to work. Let's see the help contents. Seems to work. And then I guess that's about, I said it's desktop background. Jesus. Show containing folder. This actually means that it needs to execute Nautilus. And let's first things first, guys, because this is don't audit it, so we don't have to. So actually looking pretty good so far. Look at it, it's going all the way nuts. Yeah, looking good. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to allow Eye of Gnome to run Nautilus with a domain transition. So we need to basically, and a lot of these programs do it, so we need to basically create a run Nautilus. So we does the same as stuff again. So I'm just going to attribute, and this needs to be in order. Runs Nautilus. This needs to go up eventually, but where we do that we'll see later. Actually it needs to go above shell at least, and above Eye of Gnome. So not only the shell runs it, and I'll just copy this over so that I know that I need to do that. Comment that. That's it, I think. Yeah, runs Nautilus. And then I need to go to shell, G shell, and assign the runs Nautilus to G shell. So G shell runs events, but it also runs Nautilus. Runs Nautilus, but also Eye of Gnome runs Nautilus. EOG runs Nautilus, and a lot of other stuff. But first things first. So that should see if this builds, because I probably need to move it up. Yeah, so yeah, which is the first one, this one, I guess. So attribute runs Nautilus, and then the next one, and then the next one, next one, and this can be removed. Yeah, a lot of these apps have that functionality, open in folder, probably also events. So now I can basically say, okay, open a open containing folder, and it's going to open it. At least that's the main idea, but some doesn't seem to work. Let's see why that is. Doesn't be seem to be showing anything. That's probably chatting. There's a lot of chatting going on that I've been overlooking. There's a lot of chat. I haven't checked the Dbus stuff in a while. So actually, let's just less var log message, because now it's probably also getting going nuts again. See, here we have a lot of stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So make it 20. Tail end 20. And 20. Audit to allow. I have gnome. And Nautilus wants to send a message to itself. So first things first, Eye of Gnome. Does a lot more chatting. So all these components, these DVFS components. So that was when it's why it's failing. See, if it can't chat, then it's just crapping out, and in many cases it's actually just also brute forcing, and that's pity. Awful pity. So we allow this one to self copy. It wants to, it actually Dbus chats to itself. That's okay. Oops, allow, this is not right. Forgot space. It happens. And now it should probably work, since I allowed it to debus jet. Yeah, yeah. Oh, this is nothing. Fine, cool. So I don't have to rush for that. So now it's allowed to debus jet. See if I can now open the image in the containing folder. Yeah. So now that works. Let's see if I have any ABC denials with regard to that. It's 11:49:50, but take it a minute. And these are don't audit it. Let's grab pulse home tea. If it's reading pulse cookie, then I'm going to allow it. Grab pulse. But it isn't. Oh yeah, it is. I'm going to allow it to read pulse cookie. Let's first look for pulse cookie. Nah, I can't. Oops. Something was. I allowed something to read pulse cookie. Yeah, this here. I'm going to allow now to list the same thing. Where is notes? Just because that might just be needed. I'll just add it here. So now I'm at a point where I'm just going to try it in a forcing mode without ABC denials, hopefully without ABC denials, without don't audit. And actually I forgot that as well. No. EOG, we're at a point now where I can actually comment out this stuff here. So it's really, oh, this is not actually doing it all the way properly. But we're actually getting somewhere. The thump wasn't displaying all that nice. Not sure why that is. Etsy module B. Log out after that. Clear the directory. And then basically we are enforcing and silently denying stuff. And then I'm just going to see how the experience would be. And then I'm going to take a break. And then we did another app. Another day, another app, so to speak. And if you keep on doing this consistently, then you're getting somewhere eventually. So, see if I can get to the kilos. And also just type it in. So get enforce, enforcing our search. Clean. Login. This is enforcing with don't edit rules inserted, so stuff is silently denied. And just try some stuff out, like I would be like I don't know. So we need to first find a PDF, a PNG. So we're going to use a share. Share backgrounds, spherical cow in this case, default normalish, and then we have this here, and it basically also makes a nice thumbnails, so the thumbnailing seems to work. And then you have set as wallpaper, but that doesn't work, probably. That's likely doesn't work. So now we're viewing it. Let's just see the help page for this program. So yeah, there's all kinds of help. I just wanna print this one, or I wanna print it, but I wanna preview it first. Now this is taking a long time, so there's something not right. And this is it, yeah. So I was looking at for this earlier. This is interesting. Read and unlink. Yelp empty. So, events. This is something common. And all the way below, is it? Here. And now we also add Yelp empty here. Yelp empty. Yeah, and this is for the print preview. I was looking for that, and I was wondering why isn't it there? And now I know. Now I know. See? This is it. That was that rule that actually blocked that access. So, oh yeah, now I need to actually print it. Print to file, just print it to documents. So that's that. And so what else do we have here? Show file containing full letter. Yeah, this is the open. So here we have full file system. So I could go to user share here as well. User share. And then backgrounds. And then image. Oh, not image. Oh, I'll open another one. Open. Let's see. It wants to write to temp.t. Let's have a look at that. thumpHumpty. What is it currently allowed to do to thumpHumpty here? So this sucks. I was grouping that, but it's actually trying to. Right, so I can't actually do that. It's actually trying to create a file in there. So need to try that again. Get attribute, right. Add name. First things first. I should probably also be allowed to create thumbnail there. But it was already there because you we opened Nautilus. Let's first things first. And let's just see. What we get. But yeah, it's probably going to have to be able to create the thumbnails there with a proper type. I guess. So let's just open the image. And you have even open width. That sucks. File system. User. Share. Backgrounds. Images. And then just ladybugs. Let's see what we have this time. Yeah. Actually creating content in there, and that probably also applies to others. So let's do let's look for thumpHumpty and find the appropriate set of rules. See, this needs to be changed. This is it. This is it. All these mothers need to do that. So anyone now actually interacting with thumpHome, they actually need to do this stuff. I doubt GVFS trash needs it. And recent needs it. But the user applications, not the services. This is all fine, but this here. Okay, we already had some cache, hadn't we? No, we hadn't. Now we have. Oh, damn. I would have expected events to need the same thing, but seems doesn't. So now clean. Okay, so now that works. So it actually had to mess with thumbnails for some reason. Let's save as. Save that to my login user. Let's have a look at search recently used. My login user. Save that. Have a look. Nothing to do. Less for log messages. And we have some stuff here. I have gnome chatting to G session. I have gnome, yeah, chatting to G session. So just copy over this one here. Oops, man. I have gnome D session. D session. So there was just this lost one. So what else would it need to do? Turn it around a little bit. Look at the details. Opening it in Nautilus. Nautilus has a nice thumbnail there, so thumbnailing seems to work. Recent. Now not all ladybugs, flowers, not all seem to, oh yeah, no, I'm not sure why some stuff does thumbnail and others doesn't. Not sure why that is. Go to the next image. So yeah, it seems to actually do most slideshow plugins. Now yeah, plugins might not fully work. Help should work. Yelp, yeah. So close, close, close without saving. Documents, this thumbnails work. Seems to work. Let's have a look at ABC denials. We have recent actually reading ACSFS. Recent reading ACSFS. DVFSD recent, DVFSD recent, and it doesn't have any business with SysFS. doesn't seem to. Doesn't seem to be having any business with Sisyphus yet. But we could just allow that. Make sure. I'll just allow this. So, there's more. Durreed. And then there's a file. I'm going to have a look at some other DVFS, Sisyphus stuff. This doesn't make sense. Oh yeah, that does make sense actually. Because that's not a domain. Where is GVFS? The recent. Recent is reading. I'll just do it like that. Although that's probably the long, the hard way compared to the other way around. It's probably needing to read Sisyphus, and that's no problem to me. I don't think that's an issue. Alright, take care of that. So we're pretty much done. There's always some loose ends, always. But generally the stuff works. Generally. So that's just pretty damn neat. Now we can actually open these pictures. We haven't done a shot well yet, so that's not going to work, obviously. Oh, it doesn't even actually give me a nice ABC denial or a nice block, but that doesn't actually work, of course, because yeah, you can probably see it in the latest or you see, so it's denied access to run generic bin. That's cool, that's the idea. None of these programs, or at least most of these programs, shouldn't just be able to run generic binaries. It's not such a big deal, but rather not at this point. There are some programs, like for example FileRoller can execute generic binaries because it just has to, because yeah, it just basically has to run gzip, tar, all these utilities. But we should keep that for the latest, basically, just to make sure that it's just small utilities that it runs, and then we don't have to basically domain transition. But we need to basically see if that's at all needed, if it at all needs to run these simple help utilities. And if it's not needed, then just don't allow it, and else just wait for it until we're sure that it's that it works otherwise, and then add that later at the last step. But yeah, I would have expected GNOME to give a nice error denied message, but seems it doesn't. Maybe that's because of DBus? No, it doesn't seem to be because of DBus. So alright, so I'm going to leave it at that. So we did another application. I'll just remove this. And that's set up as wallpaper. Yeah, I need to. I actually should probably deal with that right now. I should probably deal with that. So let's just see what it needs to do that. Actual factual. I'm doing this the other way. Set of force. Damn. Actually, no. I'm just gonna do it this way. Shit. And then you have G settings. Nautilus is creating a file. Now let's look at this stuff. What's going on? What the hell is going on? So these settings, Nautilus is actually creating that file in wallpapers. Aha. So in this case, Nautilus is actually also creating . So yeah, let's deal with that first. Nautilus need to be able to create files. And also with a file type transition. Well, actually, that's not quite true, but it needs to be able to create files. This one, and then decent cache, let's grab cache. G-settings needs to read. First things first, grab cache. Wallpaper. And so there, lsolz home, my login user, cache, wallpaper. FC, cache. Wallpaper. Not sure why I'm actually creating a private type for this, but so here, type wall pay cache home t type attribute wallpaper cache home t, and this is a file type. But also use a home type. Then basically it actually needs to write add name and then it actually needs to okay, that's right, add name and create a wallpaper. Cache home cheater, and then it actually needs to create file wallpaper. Cache home t, not add name, right? Not search, search. You don't search files. Create, open. Something like that, and then a type transition. There. That's called wallpaper. It seems to be at least a start. Might probably also need to unlink. Write, read, I might actually add a read as well. Create, write, search, get attribute. Needs to add name, yeah. Probably needs to remove name. I might want to lock the file. Wallpaper, is that right? Yeah, that's right. Let's have a look what else it's need at grep. User home t. It's reading user home t files, but that's not right. Actually, it might be right, but we can't actually do that right now. So make. As a module. I'm going to do this short in the shortcut. Wait. And then if there's bugs, then I'll figure it out later. But just set up the basics. Restore com. R. V. F. Home. My login user, and then it's cache, and then it's resetting some stuff there. Now I'm going to do this stuff all over again. So basically, I'm going to send a force one. So I'm going to go to the thing, user, share, background, spherical cow, default, normalish, oh, actually try some other backgrounds, images, and take this one, Stonebird. Let's just copy that one over to home, paste that in and see what. Error opening file. So let's just have a look at that. User home. Yeah, it's actually creating. Yeah, so it actually needs to do that. Makes sense. Cancel this, build this, it needs to basically be able to copy that file from user share to the user home directory, but there was no actual transition specified, so it wanted to create that file with the generic user home directory type, which is of course bad. We don't want any files with that type, so we added the type transition for files, and that should take care of that, because it should be able to create generic content files. Let's try another one. Copy this over. Go to the user home directory and paste that in. And now it's allowed. And then let's just have a look at that. 2.8. It's all stuff that we can ignore. Yeah, so that's fine. And now we can try to set that as a background. And that doesn't work. At 2.9. But there's some stuff missing there. Gset searches user home. Set B searches user home, and that makes sense. Oh, actually makes sense. That actually doesn't necessarily make sense. Pictures. and that's that pictures wallpaper stuff. So yeah, it might make sense. Because how the hell is it going to create that, be able to get there? If it can't search it. Here we have Sisyphus link file read. Oh, that's different, that's different. But we can copy this over anyways, because Nautilus wants to also read Sisyphus. So yeah, it wants to basically create that wallpaper stuff there, but it needs to be able to get there, and that wallpaper stuff, it needs to copy that file there or something. I'm not sure how that works. Basically, it's copying that file to the wallpaper there in Pictures Wallpapers, I guess. Something is doing that. Maybe it's just trying to read it. Not sure, we'll see. That's not a hit. And then it's actually trying to read the file, and there as well. Full. Read to there. That's probably also open then. Then get attribute read open the file. I'll make a note here because that might become confusing. Set wallpaper pictures wallpaper, something like that. Try that again, and now it's actually automatically working, because it can now read. Might be some bugs in that here remaining. And then it's actually also reading cache there. Reading the cache there. Anyways, I'll leave it at this. I'll try one more. And then I'll leave it at that. Wait, as module B. so many scenarios. So many functionality that you basically need to support in a desktop environment. That's allowed. Let's far log messages just to make sure that there's no debug chatting overlooked. Doesn't seem to be any. Now we can almost go to 37 and then we should be clean. Hopefully. Go on, come on. Guess not. Now we're clean, probably, hopefully. Alright, so let's just do this one more time. This is enforcing and stuff like that. So yeah, basically user, share, and it's backgrounds. Then let's maybe some gnome stuff. Let's do a gnome one. Oh, which one is nice? This one is pretty nicely footfall. Let's just copy this over. It can basically, let's see if it works if you directly do it from here. Seems to work. Let's see. Open the. Well, that generally it works. Exactly. There's some syscalls failing, but. Open there. If it reads, it also opens, usually most of the time. But anyway, it works. This was just one small thing that was hanging there. So now it works. Now if I go to my home, and then pictures, and then wallpapers, then they are there. So yeah, cool, works. Now I can basically probably remove these here and then it's still going to work probably. Empty trash. Empty trash. We are enforcing, aren't we? Cause yeah, we are enforcing. Because yeah, it's going reasonable quick. Snappy, reasonably snappy, not that snappy, but reasonably snappy. So yeah, that's it. I'm going to leave it at this. Seems to work roughly. Always some loose ends. Keep saying that, and yeah, that's because it's the truth. So now we have Eye of Gnome dealt with. I'll just clear up the stuff one more time. So that I can start a clean next time. A clean. Oh, there's some Yelp stuff remaining, but that should probably by now. Next time be fixed, because that was basically when Evins wasn't able to unlink this file, but I added that later, but at that time it probably for some reason left that. So this should be fixed in the future, I think, and if not, then yeah, that's just a bug, not so much in policy. So that's it, and that's it. So let's close this down.